start with new method, second method of finding the solution of the given quadratic equation. Solution of the quadratic equation by completing square method. The name of this method is completing square method. I will take directly the example and I will show that how you have to solve this example by the completing square method. The example is like this: x square plus 10x plus 2 is equal to 0. Completing square method. In completing square method, this term of the C is not the perfect square term. First of all, you have to tell me that this is the quadratic equation or not. The highest index of the variable is 2. So you have to say that this is the quadratic equation. But this last term is not the perfect square term. Completing square term means if the x plus y bracket square is equal to expansion of this x plus y bracket square is equal to x square plus 2xy plus y square. If this term square plus 2xy plus this term square, at that time this expansion you will write like this: x plus y bracket square. Means this way you have to complete the square and you have to write in the x plus y bracket square form. So here this is not the perfect square term. If this is not the perfect square term, that time let us add a suitable term to x square plus 10x. You have to add a suitable term to the x square plus 10x so that the new expression would be the complete square. So I will add in x square plus 10x, I will add k. That time new expression will be x plus y bracket square. Try to understand this method. This is the little bit hard method, but if you will observe all these things properly, that time you will understand. Then I will add k in x square plus 10x. At that time, whatever b will come, that one is the perfect square, and that one is the perfect square of x plus y bracket square. So I will write this x square as it is, 10x as it is, k as it is. I will expand this term, x plus y bracket square. You know the expansion of identity of this x plus y bracket square, x square plus 2xy plus y square. Then I will compare this 10x with 2xy. I will compare this k with y square. So I will say that 10x is equal to 2xy and k is equal to y square. So 10x is equal to 2ax. 10x is equal to 2xy. At that time, in between this 2x and y multiplication sign, 10 and x multiplication sign, this 2x and 10x are the like term. You have to transpose this 2x, this side, at that time multiplied by 2x becomes divided by 2x, and we will get the value of y. Then 10x upon 2x is equal to y. So I will say that 2 1 are 2, 2 5 are 10. This x will, you have to strike this x with this x. At that time only 5 is remain. Y is equal to 5 will come, and according to that k is equal to y square, you have to put this value of y here and we will get the value of k. So k is equal to y square, and k is equal to y square means 5 square, k is equal to, we will get the 25. Then I will write and I will say that x square plus 10x plus 25 means I will put the value of k as 25. That time this x square plus 10x will be the perfect square term. Means you have to complete the square and you have to write the expression. So I will say that x square plus 10x plus 25 be the perfect trinomial. So perfect trinomial means if the expansion is like this, x square plus 2xy plus y, that time I will say that this is the perfect trinomial. Then according to that, I will say that, but x square plus 10x plus 2 is equal to 0. Our original expression is x square plus 10x plus 2 is equal to 0. To add the perfect square term in between this, at that time once you have to add 25 and subtract 25, that time that will not change the value of this expression. So first of all, this I will write this 10x x square plus 10x plus 25 together and these two terms together, that time x square plus 10x plus 25 plus 2 minus 25 is equal to 0. Then this x square plus 10x plus 25, 25 means 5 square, and 2 minus 25 is equal to minus 23. But this is the expansion of x plus 5 bracket square. If we will expand x plus y, x plus 5 bracket square, at that time you will write this as x square plus 2 multiplied by x multiplied by 5 plus 5 square. According to that, answer will come x square plus 10x plus 25. Means the here x square plus 10x plus 25 is equal to, you will write that one is the expansion of x plus 5 bracket square. Otherwise you have to, if this one is perfect square, this one is perfect square, write first term, write third term and give the middle term sign, and you have to write the bracket square. So I will write this as x plus 5 bracket square minus 23. Then I will write this as minus 23. This 23 I will write square root of 23 bracket square, and after that I will use the identity a square minus b square is equal to a plus b in one bracket and a minus b in another bracket. In this way, this is a, this is b. I will write a plus b, a plus b, and I will write a minus b is equal to 0. And you have to compare these factors with 0. If I will compare these factors with 0, at that time this bracket is equal to 0, this bracket is equal to 0. If I want to find out the value of the x, I have to transpose these things that side, these things that side. That time this plus 5 becomes minus 5, plus 23 becomes minus 23, plus 5 becomes minus 5, minus 23 becomes plus 23. Therefore x is equal to minus 5 minus 23, and x is equal to minus 5 plus 23 are the roots of the given quadratic equation. Means in this method, if this third term is not the perfect square term, that time you have to add the suitable perfect square term in it, and you have to solve the given expression like this. So I add k here, that one is the perfect square term, that time this expression become x plus y bracket square. Then I expand this x plus y bracket square like this. I compare this 10x with 2xy and k with y square. From that I will get the value of y as 5 and value of k as 25. Then I will say that when I will add x square plus 10x, when I will add 25 in the x square plus 10x, that time that will be the perfect square trinomial. And after that, our original expression is x square plus 10x plus 2 is equal to 0. If I will add perfect square trinomial, perfect square 20, perfect square 25, 25 is the perfect square term, that time I will say that this will be the complete square term. So x square plus 10x plus 25 you have to write together, remaining 2 minus 25 you have to write together is equal to 0. Then I will write this as x square plus 10x plus 5 square minus 23. So I underline this means x plus 5 bracket square, this is the expansion of x plus 5 bracket square, minus 23 is equal to 0. After that you have to use the a square minus b square identity. So this is a plus b and this is a minus b. After that compare with 0 and find the answer. I think you understand these things. Write down properly.